Right, everyone. I got the bike out, and I want to show you how easy it is to unfold it. I already got the handlebar up, so I simply just hold on the brake, and this is the back brake right here. I simply just lift it up, turn it around, and there you go. Lift this up here. There we go. So all this time I'm actually holding on to the brake so the bike stays in place. Voila. Let's get the kickstand, or let's get the pedals in there. I should oil the springs a little bit. It feels a little sticky. And then do the same thing here. I gotta adjust the seat because mine's always down here. Let me see here. I like mine a little high. Get that lined up. Alright, done. So now I'm gonna mount you and I'm gonna give you a ride. So if you wanna. Alright. Alright, I'm all set up here. Gonna get going. Alright, everything looks good. Sorry for the noise here, forgot to tighten my helmet. You're gonna hear some clicking. Let me see, today, where am I gonna go today? There we go, helmet's on tight. Today, let's go. I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to take the railroad tracks. Let me make some adjustments here as I'm riding. Make sure the camera's set up right. Okay, great. I think this is a great experience. A little chilly today. I got my gloves on. I didn't bring my mid layer. It's already in the probably in the 50s right now. Although it's a little overcast. Got a very cool breeze. Ooh, very cool breeze. And fresh battery pack. So I charged it and got a battery in there. So there we go. Alright, so I've got a fresh battery pack. Let me see. Got the same pants, same swimming trunks on. I feel a little cold around my neck. Ooh. So wearing the same Columbia white windbreaker slash rain jacket. Does a pretty good job of breaking up the wind. And of course I have a inner layer, one of those Under Armour long sleeve shirts on. I'm also looking at the camera, make sure everything's okay. Okay, so everything looks all right. Everything looks good. All right. I got the seat up a little high, but that's all right. Hopefully that's not gonna prevent me from falling down. Cramp busters. Let's test out the cramp buster. Yep, cramp buster's still going. So I'm gonna go over the railroads here. I'm gonna go back around. I'm on gear pedal assist one, gear two. That's what I've been doing. And then here, okay, off road we go. All right. Let's go through the trees, make it a little bit more fun. I got the new camera mount. I'm I'm really liking this camera mount system here. I'm standing up now. Let's see here. Let's make sure there's no train coming from the right or from the left here. So I'm just gonna walk it through. There's no rush for me. All right, so, okay, let's get back on the bike. Let's get going here. Let's follow this little trail here. Ooh. A lot of thorns, a lot of twigs. All in my way. Just got hit in the face with a little twig branch, whatever it is. Some more coming. Let's see how the Rad Mini takes it. Takes it like a champ. Good. Excellent. Let's see if I can take it out. Get out the other side with it. Oh yeah. Whew. Alright, well that was fun. I'm gonna have to throttle right here. Throttle on the way down, and then throttle on the way up. Alright, okay, I'm gonna have to put it on pedal assist 2. I'm still on gear 2. You know, a good way to increase your power to the bike is really to lift the seat up as high as you can, to the point where your leg is almost extended out to where you can push all the way down on the pedal. That's where you're really going to get a lot of power, believe it or not, if you want to increase your speed and your strength into the bike. And looks like the mount is doing really well. It's not moving or jiggling during the whole bumps. I like this mount. This mount's doing really good. Okay. And I'm pedaling all this time on pedal assist 2. Whew. Let me get over here. There's one car coming. I think I can beat them. So I'm just going back the other way from what I came from. Originally, this was what the trail I was gonna originally take, because I forgot my battery last time. I had to go back home and get it. But this time I'm just gonna go back. This is the original part of the trail I was going to take. I'm gonna go mostly off-roading. There we go. I'll leave it on pedal assist 2, gear 2. I may even put up the gear 3. Alright. And it looks like the camera is about 50% of horizon, 50% ground, so I'm happy with that. You can kind of see the sky, you can kind of see the ground. It is overcast, so the lighting should be really good today. Got a nice, even lighting. All right. Pedal assist 2, gear 3 is too easy. Let me put it on pedal assist 1. I want to get some kind of, I want to warm up a little bit. I don't want to stay cold. So, a little chilly this morning. but riding around should warm me up real quick. Okay. Ooh. Yeah, feels good. Just enjoy the ride. That's what I'm doing. I'm just enjoying the ride here. Oh, boy, what am I going to talk about today? Well, I don't know. I guess I'll talk a little bit about what I like doing other than riding my bike all the time. I don't know if you noticed, if you see my channel, once in a while I do a live stream called James Bond Bitcoin Live, and my name's really not James Bond, of course, but I'm into cryptocurrency, or I should say I'm just into Bitcoin. All the other cryptocurrencies are, in my opinion, not worth putting your money in, but if you get it for free, hold on to them. But if you're gonna buy it, I wouldn't waste your time or money. But that's not all the stuff I'm into. Maybe some of you already know. You've been watching my channel since I've been doing Bitcoin videos. Anyways, today or yesterday, I took a big dump. Maybe it has a lot to do with regulations. This space was totally unregulated. People were like exit scamming, setting up pyramid schemes, Ponzi schemes. What else was going on here? Basically faking hacks on their exchanges. Back in 2013, that was going on quite a bit. That was the rage back then, to claim that you got hacked. And you, as an exchange, you lose all your customers' money. Well, recently, there's been a few exchanges that have done these things. They've been hacked, and then they would socialize the losses with their customer base, or they would essentially monetize it through their own coin offering until they could be repaid, their customers could be repaid. So essentially, they were creating a security in some ways, offering it to their customers as collateral, I guess, until they could repay their customers back, technically. BitPhoenix was one of those companies, and most likely, there's another one called, I think, CoinCheck, a Japanese exchange that recently got hacked with their NEM, new economy movement, which is really lame. It's a lame coin. But anyways, so I guess the regulators in the US, they got together and they're just, you know, they're looking at everything, they're saying, yeah, let's start regulating. This is getting out of hand. People are already losing money. BitConnect was a huge Ponzi scheme that exit scammed. Promoters are getting sued, and then they may be even charged for being an unlicensed broker offering unlicensed securities. So all this is happening, and you know, it just reminds me a lot of back in 2013, where you didn't, you know, when Bitcoin was the most dominant cryptocurrency, it went through a lot of its own regulation trials and tribulations, especially with the whole money transfer licensing, whether a user was a money transmitter or not. And I think all these other new coins, they got to go through their own trial and tribulations. They got to prove themselves. Because, let's face it, a lot of these coins are nothing more than cash grabs. Most of them will, as soon as the regulators come knocking, or inquiring more information about them, they're going to disappear because they had no intention of ever doing anything with their coin. So it was nothing more than hype or vaporware just to get you to buy into it. That's all it was. But if they really are true to their project, they will stand and they will fight for themselves. They will stand up for themselves. And just like how a lot of, Bitcoiners paid the price so other Bitcoiners can enjoy their freedom, so will these other coins, all these other people, these other coin users, these altcoin users, these ICO offering users, these other tokenized assets, they will pay the price. If they truly believe in what they're doing, so that others after them may enjoy their freedom. So we'll see. You know how strong a movement is, or an idea, or a thought, the power of belief is when the users of this belief, the people who believe in this system, are willing to die, take the sword, so to speak, to prove that this is not just a cash grab or a scam of some sorts. This is real, and they're willing to put their life on it. That's how you know it's a real movement, and I think that's what's going to happen in the coming months or years. We'll see who will be willing to fall on their sword to become essentially a martyr. That's kind of what I've been saying. You gotta remember, these coins, they're not a company, they're not a product, nor are they a service. They're essentially a belief system. And having a belief system is very powerful. You could argue that the dollar, the monetary, the fiat currency is a belief system, and that's all it is. And now the introduction of cryptocurrency, since it can't necessarily be counterfeited that easily, and definitely not backed by any armed government, and the fact that it's just free will of users to go out and choose to believe, it's very powerful. It may alter how we interact with each other in the real world, and to some degree it's already taking hold. You see that a lot of people have been kidnapped, robbed in the real world, in the physical world, and that's just the bad part manifesting itself into physical reality. Eventually you're going to see probably some of the positive stuff manifest into physical reality. In some ways you do. You see the Pineapple Fund. There's the Pineapple Fund, of course, if you haven't heard of that. All right, hold on. I'm going to be quiet here because I'm going to be taking a very bumpy ride here. I'm going to be going down this thing here, if I could find a path. Okay, here's the path. Found a path. I don't want to go too fast. Okay. Okay, this is where I'm going to throttle. Pedal. Alright. Alright. I'm going to throttle up here again. Oh, I think the seat is just a little bit too high. Because, man, it is like right on my when I stand up, it's right on my nuts. I'm gonna lower it just a smidgen so it doesn't bump up against my nuts when I stand up. Whew. Just a smidgen. Okay. All right, let me give that a try now. Whew. Yeah, it's a little bit better. Let me see here. I should, I'll just take this granite, decomposed granite path. It's not quite ready, but since my bike can just go over the hills and through the weeds without any problems, I'll take it. So this part is a continuation of the decomposed granite trail from the other side. So literally it connects one side of the community to the other. And it's a bike, they call it a bike path, which is nice. So I'm enjoying it. Gets me out of the streets and I can just ride. Go gear three now, go back to what I'm doing. Anyways, so if you're, I don't know if you're new to my channel, but if you ever see me talk about cryptocurrencies, I mainly talk about Bitcoin for the most part. It is very interesting. You definitely do fall into a rabbit hole. I mean, you go in for the money, you come out as a believer some way, or a disbeliever, one or the other. You know, you start off thinking you're gonna make money, get rich, and that's how most people come in, and most people get stuck at that point. They come for the money, and that's all they come for, and they, when the money's not there anymore, they leave for the money as well. So let me see, I think I can go on the dirt. I don't want to disturb the concrete path they laid here. So I'm just going to... Okay, it's not that muddy. Oh, they're over here working. So I'm going to take the... I was throttling, by the way, if you wanted to know. I was on gear 3 throttling. But I was pedaling and assisting. Whew. All right. So I'm still pedaling, which is nice. All right. That cramp buster, I'm telling you, makes a world of difference. Although it does pinch my hand when I'm wearing the glove. Maybe if I move it up a little bit, let's see how that feels. A little bit better. What I like about the cramp buster is that you can move it around, up and down, and depending on how you need to use it. Anyways, that's enough rant about my Bitcoin stuff. Or maybe not. Maybe I'll talk a little bit more. Like, people come in for the money. And some, you know, that's all they do is they stay for the money. And they never go beyond that. And when the money dries, they go away. It's like that simple. Right. And then they go away and they never come back. Or if they do come back, that's only when the money's returned. And, you know, they go into this cycle where I think they're constantly, in my opinion, they're constantly missing out. They come in for the money when, like, the pop has already happened, or they fool around too much in the beginning to the point where they don't really accumulate enough. They're just playing around, playing Mr. Day Trader. And then when the pop happens, they made money, but they would have made significantly a lot more money, tremendously. Maybe some of them would have been millionaires when the price pops. And then, so the fact that they made money just doing nothing, they think they're geniuses. And then you see them come on YouTube or talk to their friends and family about how they made X amount of money, but they really didn't make any money. Most likely they're involved in some kind of pyramid or Ponzi. Oh, they eventually get into pyramids and Ponzi's because they think they have all this extra disposable money here. So they get involved with like BitConnect and whatever, Dovercoin or CoinFile, Filecoin. I don't know. I mean, there's so many Ponzi's and multi-level marketing. Some of the coins are themselves are Ponzi's and multi-level marketing, like Steemit. Steemit is, in my opinion, a Ponzi-ish multi-level marketing that essentially is heavily censored. I don't know why they call it a decentralized social network. It's nothing decentralized about it. And there's no limit on that coin. And so they start branching out into these different projects, and all these coins are popping. But if you ever ask them, like, have they cashed out? Have they bought anything with it? They'll say, yeah, I bought, like, I don't know. What would they buy? I don't know. They buy a bicycle for the kid or so. They buy something small. But you notice that they can't cash out and buy, like, a house, a yacht, and some property. You know, they can't do that all at once. So, you know, they'll buy something a little bit more expensive, mainly because they're paid in Bitcoin, if anything else. But of all the coins that they have, these altcoins, what ends up happening is you can't cash out of these altcoins. There is no market for it. So what they end up doing is they end up cashing out into trading everything out into Bitcoin, and then from there, Bitcoin to whatever cash. If they can, sometimes they can't. I mean, even Bitcoin's hard to cash out too. And it used to be you could do it with a credit card, it was real easy. Now it's even harder to get money through your credit card. So these people who talk about how much money they made, I'm just very skeptical. I kind of know because I'm myself involved in the peer-to-peer market. And even then, for me, it's, you know, it's not like if I want to cash out $1 million, there's a buyer waiting for me to cash out at the price that I want for $1 million. It just, you know, it just doesn't quite happen that way. So, anyways, market's tanking right now, and these people that are holding bags that haven't already cashed out the Bitcoin, and the people who are cashing out the Bitcoin, driving the price down, I mean, all their gains are now becoming, you know, okay gains. Eventually it'll become their loss, eventually. And those people who are involved and they came here for the money, that's it, they'll be gone. No more. And I'll tell you right now that as soon as all those people leave, that's probably the best time to buy Bitcoin, because the price would be driven down. All the people who are here for the money and left for the money, they'll sell all their coins to get out. They'll essentially become losers now, and they'll too ashamed to ever talk about Bitcoin or get back into Bitcoin, hopefully. Or maybe they'll learn their lesson and they'll realize how the game really works. And then that's probably the best time to get in, because you want to get in when there's no demand, no one cares, it's not being hyped. That's the best time to get in. And then all you have to do is sit back and wait, and then let the new noobs and fools and former fools who come back drive up the price for you, and let them give you all their money, essentially. So once you learn the game, I mean, it's very possible to have a life in cryptocurrency. you just have to be smart. You have to be an intelligent investor, or just have some intelligence, I should say. I mean, you don't have to be an investor. Just understand how the game works. Once you understand the game and you understand the rules, then you'll become a better player. And that's all it is. That's all essentially it is. And all we have is a bunch of new people who think they struck gold. And now they think they're whiz kids. But in reality, they're just the greater fool, essentially. That's what they are. They just don't realize it now. All right, that was a nice, enjoyable ride. I'm still on pedal assist one. I am warm. I'm working up. I feel warm now, so that's good. I'm liking this camera mount. It suits me just fine. Oh. So all the time I was on pedal assist one, gear three, and having the seat up a little bit higher works out pretty good. I get full extension on my legs, and so now I'm headed to the sports complex. Man, it looks like they're building that wall pretty good. On the other side, there's probably a railroad, the railroad system. And the camera mount's handling these bumps really good. Awesome. Let's ring the bell for these guys. Alright. Still on pedal assist one, gear three. I'll leave it on that. Maybe I'll go to gear four, get up some speed and momentum. Get up some momentum for that little incline that I'm gonna go and hit. And then after that, I'll go into a decline. So let me just pedal a little bit faster here. I'm still sitting down and all right, made it. Go to gear seven to keep up with the decline. Ooh. Eventually I have to shift down. It gets a little hard. All right, I'm on six. Five, gear five here. Still on pedal assist one. I have to say, even though I'm riding electric bike, I am building up pretty good endurance and muscle on my legs. The electric bike just makes it more fun and easier. And I get to travel longer. Let me see, I'm on gear five, four, three. Let's see if I can make it up with three on pedal assist one. Yes. Yes, I can. Oh, yeah. Oh, yes, I did it. Just that little assistance. It's like having a spotter, if you want to think of it that way. Or I'm just coasting right now. So essentially it's like having a spotter. But you're letting the electric motor spot you. And so when I need that extra, just a little extra help, that pedal assist one that gives me about 30 to 50 watts of power, it helps. It's not doing a whole lot, but it's giving you that extra, just that extra help to get your muscles working instead of exhausting that muscle to the point where it deters your motivation. And the fact that I go off terrain, it helps because it works out the muscle differently. You have to kind of you push harder and it's more of a resistance kind of training versus weightlift training. And I just feel like I'm constantly putting tension on the muscle no matter where I am versus weight training. You know, you lift something and then when you putting it down, you're just letting gravity take over. And you know, sometimes you see people in the gym swinging the barbells and stuff like that. This is different. It's no matter where you are, it's just the resistance, and it's not based on the weight, it's just based on how much you're pedaling, kind of, if you know what I'm talking about. Anyways, this morning air is making my nose a little runny. Alright, I'm on gear 3, pedal assist 1. I've been on gear 3, pedal assist 1 most of this time, and I have to tell you, if you bike every day and you do put effort into it, you know, you don't let the motor do all the work for you, you will build strength and muscle in your legs. And you know what I noticed when I went to the fitness center was that out of all the exercise machines, the treadmill, the stair machine, or the bicycle machine, out of those three, the bicycle machine gave me the most workout. I felt more exhausted. I felt my legs getting sore. Second was probably the Stairmaster. That gave me the second best workout for what it is, you know, just a machine, a stationary machine. Not weightlifting or anything, and those two were probably the top two that gave me the workout. The treadmill, however, it did work up a sweat, but I didn't feel like I was getting a lot. I mean, mostly I was walking. I could have ran, but then again, compared to the effort I put in, I would have to literally run on the treadmill. To get almost the equivalent of just pedaling at a mild resistance on a bike, or slowly going up the Stairmaster, I would have to literally run on the treadmill. That's what it felt like. So when I saw this electric bike, and I saw the fat tires, I saw the Mini and the Rad Rover, and for the price they were, I mean, they're both like $1,500 each. I got it at a promotional rate. I got two, so I got an extra $200 off total. It's basically $100 off each. Man, I don't regret it. It's fun. I get to go out. I get to experience different levels of workout based on the ride, and I get to go places. It's definitely made me more active. Ooh, I'm coming out on the lookout here. Alright, alright. I think I'll take a little water break here, and then continue on, so I'll be right back. Alright. I'm ready. Hold on here. Tightening my helmet just a little bit more. Alright, adjusting the mic. And alright, I've turned around already. I'm ready to go. Oh, there we go. I've taken off my gloves, opened my jacket a little bit so I can let some of the perspiration get out. All right. Feels good. Feels great. I haven't checked the power on this thing. Man, I got about 2 hours. Ooh. Ooh. Ooh, I feel that wind. Maybe I should put on my gloves. It's still a little cold, so. Hold on here. All right, there we go. I'm gonna put the gloves on. I am warm, but just felt a sudden gust of wind here that made me change my mind. It is cool this morning. All right, hands are warm. That way I could touch the buttons. There we go. Pedal assist one, gear three. I'm headed to the lookout now. So, anyways, I got the zipper open, so, or my jacket zipper open. I should clarify that. All right. I'm cooling down pretty quick. Faster than I expected. Oh boy. All right. Whew. Looks like it's about 2 hours of ride. So, wow. You know, I can't believe raising the seat up to the point where I get a full leg extension on the bike made that much of a difference in riding it. So if you're struggling a little bit, ooh, it's getting a little windy. I might have to zip up the jacket now. I feel a little wind. I think there's about 10 to 15 miles an hour wind here. Gusts of up to 20, possibly up to 20. Every once in a while you get people who, you know, there's supposedly a bike trail, quote unquote, here. Other than the trail that I'm on and I've been going on, I don't see any other, but on the Google Maps, it shows like a bike trail along the river. I don't think it's really a bike trail, quote unquote. It could be a hiking trail. Of course, a lot of the erosion, well, there's been a lot of erosion. There might have been a trail at one point, a little walking trail, maybe a bike trail, but it's eroded. So I don't know what that guy's gonna do, where he plans on walking, but unless he's just walking in a circle, which, you know, still good exercise. Still good exercise. All right. Let's get back to biking. That was quick. Going down to gear two, take a little bit slower. All right. Put down to gear one. Make that small, tight turn. Just to show you, I guess. Other than just to show you, tight turns are, you make some good tight turns on the Rad Mini. All right. Whew. There we go. Yeah, that seat, you know, just raising the seat up high enough where you get a full leg extension on to the pedals makes a huge difference. I'm just literally on gear 3, pedal assist 1. Then again, I might have developed some good strength in my legs now to do this. How you doing? Maybe he's out here fishing. You can go down to the river and go fishing if you wanted to. Who knows? I'm looking at the time here, see how much time I have. Seems like I got plenty of time since I didn't have to go back to the house and get a battery pack. I got a fresh one right here. It looks like everything's drying up here. Excellent. Maybe I could follow this trail here. Follow this side of the trail. It was really wet and muddy. Okay, I think it's traversable, if that's, is that a word that I just made? Traversable. There's a lot of water there. Why not? It is a Rad Mini, I know I can take it. Let's go down to gear 1, so. I'm gonna need power pedal assist 2. Oh, I don't have my rain gear. Come on, make it through. Oh, don't get stuck. Okay. Oh, that mud really sticking. I haven't seen the back of my tire. I feel it slipping. No. Great. It did slip. Got my front left foot into the mud a little bit. That's all right. I'll swipe it on the grass here. Well, it did slip, but didn't fall. Made it far enough. Let's avoid some of this mud. All right, not too bad. Didn't want to get off the bike, but you know what? It's either get off the bike let me see how bad the the back wheel's covered in mud, but nothing too thick. I think the fenders are gonna handle it just fine. Not like that time I went off and really did a dirt ride. That was muddy. That was muddy. Oh boy. Whew. Okay, well, that's all right. I'm just learning the capabilities of your Rad Mini to truly understand what you can and can't do with it. You just can't, you know, do anything you want with it. It doesn't work that way. Okay, now let me go on pavement from here on out. Yeah, that wheel is pretty muddy. Go on pedal assist 2, gear 3. Let me get going back up here. I'm still exploring the areas around here. I'm trying to get a good idea of where I can and can't go. I think there's a lot of unexplored areas. It's getting cold. I have to zip up. I feel that wind coming on me now. Increase the. Going to go to gear 7. still on pedal assist too. Alright, I'm all zipped up. Alright, time to put pedal assist 5. Fling some of that mud off. Ooh. Alright. There I go, going 20 miles an hour. Let's see, 20. Pedaling really hard now. 20 miles an hour, 20.2. Ooh, got a little wind in front of me. In my rear view mirror, no one's behind me. Ooh, I'm at 19.8 19.7 20. I do have some headwind here, and I'm on pedal assist 5, gear 7, and I am really pushing on the pedals here. I feel my legs being sore. It is cold. I feel a little chilly. Oh, here comes a car. Down to 1 bar already. Alright. Just letting it cruise. I gotta cross over. Shifting down to gear 3. Okay, putting it down to pedal assist 1. To give you an idea what kind of weather this is, it's kind of like the weather where you get a runny nose from the coldness, but it doesn't dry because it's not that cold. That kind of weather. Let's have a look at the wheels. Well, they're muddy, but the mud didn't cake on. I felt some debris fly up at me, but nothing like when I didn't have full fenders. So full fenders makes a huge difference. Really does. Let's see, where am I gonna go now? I just gotta make a full circle, go to Sports Complex. Let me see. Sports Complex, I don't know, let's go over the hill, why not? You want to see what it looks like on the hill as I ride up and down? That's fine, let's do that. It gives me a good workout. Not really a hill test, but if you want to see me ride up and down the hill, I guess I'll do that. And then finally to the second fitness center, and I'm all right. Now I'm just cruising along right now and letting the power, I wouldn't say regenerate, but on the display it shows me that I have five bars of power now. When I go up to pedal assist or a full throttle, it does drain out that battery real quick. So I notice if you use the throttle less in a really controlled manner without going full throttle or full pedal assist, the battery does seem to last longer, at least on the display. But when you are like pedal assist 5 and full throttling, it does drain it. And even the amount of bike riding I've done, even though it says like I have a full bank of power, when I go home and I charge this battery, it still takes about 6 hours, even with this much. One time I did almost drain it down to one bar. Actually, the bar was flashing. It took almost 8 hours. I would almost say 9 hours, pretty much all day, to recharge that battery. Ooh. So, pedal assist 1, gear 3, I'm just mostly on my own power. It's only using about 30 to 50 watts of power. Eventually I'm gonna get to the hill eventually. Just using most of my own leg power to get there. Because I still want to work out, but at the same time I still want to have fun. I don't want riding a bike to become a workout. You know what I'm saying? I want it to become a part of my daily activity. And the benefits are exercise, strength, endurance, well-being, mental fitness as well. Because, you know, when you ride this bike, you have to like downshift, upshift, power assist up, power assist down, throttle. You gotta use some of you gotta use your brain. And every time you ride on out there, even though you may take the same path, it's different every time. So I know that sounds like trivial, but it does make a difference. It really gets you to think, exercise. You have to think about the gear you're gonna wear. You have to consider the weather. You have to do a lot of things here. And on top of that, make it fit within your schedule. Whether you're single, you're married, you're dating, you know, whatever your work, you don't work, you're rich, you're poor, you're retired, you're not retired, semi-retired, whatever the case may be. So, I'm gonna shift down a little bit. So I'm gonna first go from the backside on up. Ooh, I'm getting a little heated here, so I gotta unzip the jacket, let some of that perspiration out, that heat out. Okay. I'm gonna go pedal assist 5. I know I'm not gonna make it, so I'm not even gonna like pretend I'm. Or try. So, okay, I'm gonna get a head start here. This may actually drain the battery more, but all right. Oh, I still have to push a lot. Sorry, I had to spit a little bit. All right. Well, hopefully you got to experience that on the way back up to I'm just gonna follow that trail. This side is not a problem. This side is real easy. I was on gear 2 that whole time, so all right, my legs are getting stronger. And going over these roots are really bumpy. But let me tell you, these shocks are amazing. Even though they're on the Rad Mini, that little bit of shock suspension really makes a difference. I don't know if you could tell or see it in the camera, but I have to say, I think it does make a difference. I just leave the suspensions on because I know I'm gonna be going off the road, off the pavement all the time. Even touch the throttle yet. Most of this has been my own work, and let me tell you, it's just that little bit of help. I'm going down to power assist 1. That little bit of help just helps you keep going and going and going. And especially if you're riding on these paved roads or sidewalks, man, this is like cutting through butter. After you go off-roading on this bike, you go through some thick bush, thick grass, unpaved road, your legs feel conditioned and toned. And when you go on these on the road or on the sidewalks, it's like cutting through butter. And you can go and pedal assist 1. Maybe if I really want to challenge myself, I'll go pedal assist 0. But, nah. That takes too much fun out of it. I got a green light, but there's a whole bunch of cars coming. Probably have to slow down. I could take it. I don't see any cars behind me. Alright, excellent. I use the throttle on that, by the way, if you're all curious. I use the throttle. Oh, that mirror comes in handy. I don't have to turn my head all the way around. Just a quick look to the left, look in the mirror, and I can tell if anyone's behind me trying to make that right turn while I cross the sidewalk, and the crosswalk, I should say. Okay, I'm on gear 4, pedal assist 1. Which is now really easy. I have to say, riding this bike has really helped me condition my legs, and I don't have to go like fast, hard all the time or be in a hurry. I just have to enjoy the ride and ride for a few hours, 3 hours, 4 hours. I mean, you can, and it takes me places. And if you are fortunate to live in a somewhat, you know, suburban area where you have, like, you know, streets and sidewalks, semi, you know, city-ish type of area, but at the same time you have a lot of open fields and trail rides and just off-terrain, off-road places to go, this bike is perfect. And especially if you like the portability and you also like to, you know, still have your car. I didn't get this bike because I want to get rid of my car. I got this bike so I can use it with my car and get some exercise. So that's a That's the difference here. Use it with your bike. Use your car with your bike and don't drive as much. So that's my take on it. I mean, everyone has their own unique situation, which I respect. Ooh. Man, I see all these places where I could just go a little off-roading, but I'm not. I'll do that in my own time. And if it's really enjoyable, I'll share it with you. Still on pedal assist 1, now I'm on gear 5. So yeah, most of this is just my own leg power. And yeah, I can just keep going. Again, just that little help just makes the ride very enjoyable. I guess you could do it without any. It would really give you a workout. I don't see anybody behind me here. I'm looking in the mirror, so that's good. And I can just throttle. All right. There we go. Let me get up to speed here. All right, so now that I'm on this road, I might go and go to pedal assist 5. Pedal assist 5, gear 7. Go to gear 7. No one's on the road here. There's a truck coming up behind me, but I'm sure it won't be a problem passing me. Alright. Whew. Pick up speed. Four miles an hour. Man, am I pedaling? I'm pedaling too. Here comes a work truck. Power it down a little bit. Shift down on the gear. I might just even throttle a little bit. Or let's just have some fun and go a little off-road. Let's just check out the new pool. Hold on. I'm hoping by summer they'll have this pool open. Get to enjoy it. Let's have a quick look at it. Have a nice lake view. Oh yeah, look at that. Really nice. Okay. A lot of chairs. They have a covered area. I'm gonna enjoy this on a hot summer day in Houston. Wow. It's gonna be nice to have that pool. Oh. I think they're gonna open one March. Hopefully March, maybe January, February, March, April, May, maybe in May. Some other areas to look at. They have it like a little beach boardwalk kind of style. A little fishing theme to it. You can see little fish hooks on the gate over here. Wow, looks really nice. Not any deep area, just walking area. Oh, this is sand. Oh, they got a little sand area right here. This is sand. I thought this was paved. So they make it, I guess they're trying to give a theme of like it's a beach. So people could go, kids could build some sand castles and whatnot. They haven't completely fenced the area yet. I don't know what the plans are. Hopefully they're gonna make it a little bit more fun. All right. Can't wait. I love this thumb throttle. Just enjoying the ride. I want to see the lake view. There's the lake view. Actually, you could call it a lake. It's really a retention pond, but you know, we'll call it a lake view. Why not? The mud's not that wet around here. It's pretty compact and dry. Crambuster really gives me a really good control and still allows me to have grip on the handlebar. Oh yeah. And again, I can also just pedal, put on gear one. More off-road before I head in, and I'm at the second fitness center, so I'm just gonna take a rest here. Maybe I'll ride some more, maybe not, who knows. I have to charge the camera phone here. Eventually I'm gonna have to tune this bike. I'm kind of curious if it's need truing and all this other stuff. Just walk it. All right. That's all right. I'll be right back. All right. I've had some good time resting here. I'm gonna actually put you on to the chest mount and see how this works out. Hopefully it works out a lot better. I might have to readjust it when I eventually get on the bike here. Here, let me see. I may have to readjust it, hold on. Let me readjust the chest mount here. Okay, there we go. Okay, I think this is gonna work. Okay, so let's put the power on. I got 214 miles. All right, so this is just the chest mount. I'm doing the chest mount style. Hopefully this is good for you as it is for me. Can't even see the screen, so I don't know if it's working. working out that well, but anyways, I got my jacket open. It is a little sunny today. I spent my time here out in the cold. Whew. Okay, let's pedal sys 5, gear 7. Whew. It is cold. I can feel that wind. Alright, I'm at 17. 17, 18, 19 miles an hour. Headed back to the fitness center now. Got a good rest, got some water. Pretty windy today. I can feel that wind. I'm at 19 miles an hour here. I'm down one power bar. Got 4 bars left here. All right, I'm gonna look both ways here. Nothing. Just enjoy the ride. I'll do a little off-roading as well. Take a little shortcut here. I'm at 19.3, 19.4. Alright, now I'm at 20 miles an hour. I can feel the wind. Well, the wind's kind of back, but man, that wind really, really kills your power, your speed. Alright, now there we go. The wind's gone now. Somewhat gone. Now I feel like I'm going faster. Alright, there we go. Yeah, wind really kills you. Okay, I'm still going 20 miles an hour on the Rad Mini. Got 216 miles on this. Got you on my chest mount today. Got a car coming up. There's a truck pulling a trailer. Guy on the passenger side was looking at my bike. Ooh. You know, I was at the second fitness center, and I think there was a locksmith there. He was asking me about the Rad Rover bike. He's like the, I don't know, second person that wanted to take a picture of the bike. Down, change the gear. Or keep the same gear. Ooh, feel that wind blowing. Going hands free here. Got the buckle up on my backpack. There we go. Now my backpack's buckled up. Look to the left, look to the right, nothing. So I'm gonna go through, I guess, another Mario Land, I call it. Take the lake. Throttle. Let me just throttle it. I'm gonna throttle it. Oh. Enjoy the ride, people. Enjoy the ride. Throttling it. Got my thumb on the throttle. I could even palm it. Now I'm palming it. Okay. Let me cut across this nice little parkway they got here. Oh, I'm on fifth gear. Pedal assist 3 helps me out. Now I'm gonna throttle. Okay, I'm just throttling it because I'm just going to the fitness center anyway, so it doesn't really matter. Whew. Alright, this is where I go off to Mario Land. Alright, so now I'm gonna really throttling this. I'm standing up. I'm down 2 power bars. I only got 3 power bars left. I'm going 12 miles an hour, 13. Let's see, 13.8. I'm throttling all the way, and man, I got. Ooh, it's really bumpy. And I'm really grabbing on these handlebars really good. It's really bumpy. Going 15 miles an hour. Alright, I'm going 17 miles an hour. Ooh. 17, 16, down to 16. Down to 16. It's a lot smoother. 17, going 17 miles an hour. Oh, don't want to overshoot. Ooh, my legs are sore just from standing up. Oh, all right. It's 15 miles an hour, 16. Pedal assist 1. Go down to gear 3. Alright, well, that was fun. Whew. That was fun. I'll slow it down here. Man, I really had to grab the handlebar really good while throttling. Crambuster helped quite a bit. My legs were absorbing all the shocks, all the bouncing, so got a good workout on my leg. My arms kind of it was jiggly, really jiggly. Oh goodness. Anyways, the mirror's all out of place as well. There we go. Oh man, riding on pavement feels like butter now. Riding through butter, just cutting through hot, warm butter. All right, I'm back at the fitness center, everybody. Whew. All right, well, hopefully y'all enjoyed this episode. Feel free to like, dislike, leave a comment or even do a video response. Hope you like the chest mount. I'm gonna end this video right here.